Sanjay, can you explain us the concept of transforming IT that you are talking here in the CIABI?
Sure. So what I shared at the keynote was that businesses today have a lot of pressure on three fronts. One, they have to do more with less, drive more efficiency into the business, whether you're a financial institution or a retail institution, it doesn't matter. You have to do more with less. Mm-hmm. Two, you have to come up with new ways to grow your revenue, to increase your market share, to grow your business. All of this done in a safe and trusted way, right? Mm-hmm. Reduce your risk. There's no way to do that today without technology. So what I shared with the team earlier was that if you want to do more with less, technology like cloud computing really give you the ability to scale out your capabilities at the same time reduce your operating expenses. Mm-hmm. If you want to grow your top line, your revenue, technologies like big data really enable your business to take information and use it in a predictive way to really do analytics and things that you couldn't do yesterday with the information that you had. And all of that on a platform that is safe and secure, so your interactions with your customers are trusted, compliant, and reliable. Mm-hmm. So there's no way to do that, no way to get more efficiency and drive more productivity or revenue in a trusted way without technology truly being the transformer. Mm-hmm. And that was the theme of the presentation that I shared today.
Okay, how do you think that the companies can deal with business and technology to better attend their clients, for example?
So the good news is that the consumers of your products are more technically savvy. They have tablets, they have smartphones, they have computers. So our customers today are more technically savvy. So they want to use technology to interact with you. So whether they're buying a shirt online or they're doing banking online, they want to be able to do it anytime, any place, any device, right? Anytime. And how do you do that? That's where technology truly becomes part of the business. It's not, here's the business and here's the technology department. The business today, there are very few businesses that aren't dependent and delivered through technology.
And do you think that this technical knowledge is good for the CIOs?
The CIO's role is always under fire. You know, I've been a CIO for many years. People keep saying, oh, CIO, career is over. You know, yeah. Not so. I think the role of the CIO has really evolved to be a true partner of the business. And the CIO today, I think, at least this way, myself and a lot of my peers think about it, is we are brokers. Our job in the company is to broker value, to bring technology, to bring new ideas, to bring new things, new process, and help the business truly be more efficient and drive more revenue. And do it in a safe way. So, there's never been a better time, in my opinion, to be the CIO or to be in IT. It's really the coming together of the two things.
Okay. Do the things in the safe way in this world of more experts, users. It's not so easy. So, the CIOs have to transform the way they act to maintain the data safe in this world?
You know, more than ever, the responsibility of any corporation that keeps information that has either financial implications for their customers or privacy implications for their customers, there is more onus on compliance and regulatory oversight, and the IT organization, the security organization, has to really, step up and take care of that. With a lot of these smart devices and where people are doing the, anytime, any place computing, the new perimeter for security is the person, yeah. Right? Because now you become you're the firewall. You've now taken company information on your phone, on your tablet, and off you go, and you're working from anywhere. So people become the new perimeter, if you could believe that. And so, the responsibility for the IT organization and the security organization around compliance and privacy is heightened, and we believe, EMC, and our security division, RSA, we believe that the best way to do this today is through big data analytics. So security, compliance, really become great use cases for big data analytics. So those are the kinds of tools that the CSO and the CIO now have to really make their jobs a little easier.
Okay, in the financial institutions here in Brazil, the security organization are seen as obstacle for IT evolution. So is it common in the rest of the world, or how do you see that?
I would say to you that like IT organizations, like business, the security organizations inside companies have to evolve. And I like to think about the fact that you're no longer securing the perimeter. You're securing, people are the new perimeter, so you have to secure the way people work. Mm-hmm. And no longer you're securing the application, you're securing the transaction. And so security tools, security approaches, partnering with the business cannot be something you bolt on at the end. It's something you build in to how you do business. Mm-hmm. So security organizations inside companies have to truly transform to be seen as a true partner in the business, and it is being done everywhere. Mm-hmm. I'm sure it's happening in Brazil. I don't think they're all obstacles to the business.
Okay, that's in the technical side, in the human side. In the technical side, we have the transformation in the data center, for example. You told about the data center as based in software.
Yeah.
How this transformed the day-by-day of CIO and the security organizations in corporations?
So what I talked about earlier was what we call the software-defined data center.
Yeah.
And the software-defined data center really abstracts intelligence to a layer that is the virtualization layer. And the virtualization layer interacts with the sort of the subsystems of compute or server, storage, and networking very closely, using the intelligence that those systems have alongside the abstracted intelligence across the data center. So we suddenly, you can now apply policy and automation and standardization across the data center and truly be agile. We've been able to do it with server. And so if you look at the savings that the server virtualizations brought to the world, it's approximately $10 billion of savings. Our study says that if you apply the same concept to networking and to storage, that number could be between $60 and $70 billion. So the efficiencies will continue, but more importantly, the operational approach that the software-defined data center brings to IT is unprecedented. And I think that's going to change the world, and it'll make the CIO's life a whole lot easier.
But this structure will be more complex or not?
No, because of standardization. Complexity is what we have today. We have one of everything today in most data centers and we live with it because of legacy, and we have one of everything. When you simplify and you standardize, you can abstract and automate. Your life becomes a whole lot simpler and a whole lot easier, quite the opposite.
How do you imagine the an IT department from here to 10 years, for example?
You're making a consultant out of me, huh, Fabio? I think that it will be a software-defined world. Mm-hmm. I said today you've already seen with cloud architecture that the IT organization is more of a consultant with the business. We have common infrastructure. We don't sit and discuss infrastructure if you have sort of a cloud-based infrastructure. So you really sort of created a factory, and now you work with the business on creating the products that they want because mm-hmm. the factory has been built. That's the infrastructure. I think you'll see more of that. You'll see more IT as a service, where IT delivers capabilities through a portal or through a catalog, and the business consumes it as they wish, as they need, okay, on an ongoing basis. It's not about you build it, and you build it for the peak load of the future. You will consume it as you need it. So IT as a service will become very real. You will see the data center becoming more software-driven. You'll see the roles of IT and the business being a little closer, okay, more consultative, more partnering. And inside of IT, you'll see new roles. You'll see roles like data scientists, data architects, data center architects, automation engineers. These are things that don't, product managers, that are not classic IT roles of yesterday, but they'll become mainstream. My belief is they'll become mainstream roles of tomorrow.
Do you think that those new professionals were born in IT departments or in business units?
Both. The business is more tech savvy. They want to do more things themselves. So things that IT did yesterday, business will do today. It's natural. User interface design. The business wants to build their own capabilities because everything they do today has a technology touch to it, right? So they want to create their brand. They want to create their capabilities. It's not an IT thing necessarily. IT will assist. So that's one example where it, you know, that will potentially move to the business or partner with the business. IT needs to be a broker of value. So what does that mean? That means whether you build, whether you buy, whether you rent, or you outsource, it doesn't matter. You have to find the best solution. And IT's role becomes of a broker, while the business really becomes the sort of the consumer of what we do. What will change is cycles. What used to take us years and that was acceptable has become months. What used to be months has become weeks. And what has become what was weeks has become automatic. I want to press a button on a catalog and get it. Mm-hmm. IT's roles will change because of automation. So this is all positive stuff. This is all good stuff. And it's happening. You know, you could see it happening today. Mm-hmm. IT gets to the things they need to do, not the things they had to do.
Okay. Do you think that in this world of broker IT, will be common to see an outsourced CIO, for example?
Yeah.
A broker can be a third part or no?
Well, I believe that, you know, that's more of a delivery mechanism. The CIO has to be a real partner of the business, has to be part of the executive team, has to be part of the, you know, part of the business strategy. And I believe that today with the things that technology allows us to do, the CIO is really that. I'm not sure that can be, the role of the CIO can be outsourced.